Hi guys, in this video, I'm gonna talk about regression using PyCaret. If the target variable is numerical, such as house prices, you can use regression models. Regression models are used for estimating the relationship between a dependent variable and one or more independent variables. Note that the dependent variable is often called the outcome or target variable. The independent variables are often called the features. So, what is the goal of regression? The goal of regression is to predict continuous values, such as predicting sales amount, predicting temperature, etc. To show this, let's use insurance dataset. To load this dataset, I'm gonna import pandas. Import pandas as pd. Let me load the insurance dataset using the readcsv method in pandas. Data equals pd.readcsv. I'm gonna set insurance csv. Let's take a look at the first 5 rows. Data.hit. Here, the charges are the target variable. Note that this variable has continuous values. The other variables are the feature variables. To predict the target variable, we can use regression analysis. To do the regression analysis using PyCaret, let me import the regression module from PyCaret.regression import. To import all function, let me set asterisk. Now, I am gonna use the setup method to initialize the analysis. This function uses data preprocessing and creates a transformation pipeline. S equals setup. Setup function takes the mandatory parameters. These are data and target. Let me set these parameters. Data, comma. I'm gonna set charges for target parameter. Target equals charges. For setup function, I'm gonna use the default values. You can see the default values on the screen. According to your dataset, you can pass your values to these parameters. Here, train size is 0.7. If you want, you can change this value. To normalize the dataset, you can use normalize parameter and specify normalize method. You can change the parameters you want. When you execute this function, PyCaret automatically finds the data types. Let's control these data types. As you can see, our data types are correct. To exit the setup, I'm gonna press enter. You can see all preprocessing and transformation in this table. For example, session ID is 6927. This controls the randomness of the experiment. The target variable charges. The structure of the original data is here. No missing data in the dataset. Numeric features are 2 and categorical features are 4. You can see the structures of train and test set. Don't forget I configured all the preprocessing and data transformation within the setup function. Cool! Our dataset is ready to build the model. To build the model, I'm gonna use the compare models method. This method trains and evaluates the performance of all estimators using cross-validation. Best equals compare models. When I run this command, the estimators are training and evaluating. Estimators are trained and matrix values are returned. You can see the metric of the estimators. The yellow areas show the estimated best matrix. By default, the best estimator was specified by the mean absolute error metric. You can use the sort parameter to find the best model based on a different metric. You can change the sort order by passing the name of the metric based on which you want to do model selection. According to mean absolute error, the graded ballistic regressor has the best accuracy score. Nice! We saw the performance of the estimators. Let's print the hyperparameter of the best estimator. Let me set print best. Here you go. You can see the hyperparameters. Now, let's take a look at the performance of the model on the test set. To do this, I'm gonna use the evaluate model function. This function displays a user interface. Evaluate model. Let me set best. You can see the performance of the best model. For example, there are hyperparameters. Let me see residuals. Here you go. To evaluate the regression model, R-square coefficient of determination metric is generally used. If this value is close to 1, the model is so good. R-square for the train is 0.909 and the test R-square is 0.856. To avoid overfitting, you'd like to close these values. Let's take a look at the best number of features. To do this, I'm gonna press the feature selection button. As you can see, the best number of feature is 11. If you select this value, you can get the best score. Let's take a look at the imported features. To do this, let me press the feature importance button. Here you go. As you can see, the most important feature is smoke or no. Next, BMI and age. Finally, let me show the learning curve. As the number of sample increases, the training score and the cross-validation score are close to each other. Don't forget evaluate model can only be used in notebook. You can also use the plot model function to generate individually. For example, let's take a look at residuals. Plot model, let me set best, comma, plot equals residuals. Here you go. You can see the important feature. Plot model best plot equals feature. Here you go. Okay, we built our model and saw its performance of the model. Now, let's take a look at how to predict the model. I'm gonna use the predict model function. This function returns the model matrix and the predictions. Let me set prediction model best. Let me run this command. Cool. Here, you can see the matrix of the model above and in the table label columns that show the predictions. To see that, let me zoom out. Note that the evaluation matrix are calculated on the testset. You can see the second output which shows the label column. According to our trained model, the prediction of the first row is about 15,000 and the real value of the sample is about 14,000. The prediction of the model is close to real value. You can see the other predictions. To predict new dataset, you can use the data parameters. To show this, for example, I'm gonna simply use our data. Let me zoom in. After that, prediction equals prediction model. Let me set the name of our model. Best, comma. I'm gonna set the data for data parameter. Data equals data. To see the first 5 predictions, let me set prediction.heat. You can see the predictions in the label column. Cool. So far, I showed you how to build the model and predict a trained model. Now, let's take a look at how to save the model. To save the model, you can use the save model function. Let me show you this. Save underscore model. First, I'm gonna paste the name of our model. Best, comma. And then, I'm gonna set a name. Let's say, my best pipeline. Let me run this. Nice. I saved the model in my working directory. You can see the pipeline of model. To load the model back in my working directory. Loaded underscore model equals load model. Let me set my best pipeline. Let's print the loaded model. Print loaded model. Here you go. You can see the pipeline for our model. Beautiful! In this video, I talk about regression using PyCaret. In short, I showed you how to preprocess the data, build and evaluate the model, predict the new data, and save and load the model. In the next video, I'll show you how to do clustering analysis using PyCaret. That's it! I hope you enjoy it! Thank you for watching! You can find the link to this notebook in the description below. Please, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, like the video, and leave a comment! See you in the next video. Bye for now.